that will really unfold what forgiveness is about. The first level of forgiveness, that is still the story. The first level of forgiveness is about me and about you as separate. It's about, there is a story and you did something to me. So the first level of forgiveness works with the story. And as you see, it's really self-centered because there is no unity consciousness yet. It's just me and you as separate. So forgiveness in that level, doesn't really exist, or the forgiveness isn't that kind of pure, because the best thing you can do is you can call that person, or you can drop into yourself and you can try to hug and forgive to that person. But because the view beneath is separated, the forgiveness won't be whole as well, or either. There will be always a remorse, there will be always a victim, because you still, or we still operate with a story. He did this to me. And forgiveness will be just an external thing. That level of forgiveness many of us only know about. And the second part of the forgiveness is when I realize that maybe I should search within me. So it's a wiser level of forgiveness. It's a level of forgiveness when I see that the other's action is actually reflecting something within me. This is a much wiser forgiveness because here we actually searching within ourselves. Somebody did something and we only and only able to see it because we hold in the same characteristics, the same features within. So that's the second level of forgiveness. When we search inside. The third level of forgiveness is what they something call as radical forgiveness. In this level, we open up to a dimension with what's maybe absolutely out of reach. So the radical forgiveness is when there is unity, when we realize that there is no victim, no story, no action. Because what really happening is that we ourselves asked for that situation to happen. We as a spiritual being, you see, at the beginning we were kind of like separate human beings. On the second level we became like semi-spiritual somehow. In the third level we realized that actually we are all one. And we are spiritual beings having a human experience here. and everything we want is everything what happened with us is actually something we wanted to experience in some way. Have it ever happened with you that something was in your life what you considered as a bad thing and it haunted you for years, and after a time you realize that somehow that's what made you who you are? In a weird, twisted way, that thing was the very thing what you needed. That thing was what made you grow and made you who you are. And that's what I'm talking about when I'm talking about the third level of forgiveness. It's that we operate from this level. We see that everything what happened has a purpose that's bigger than us, a purpose that's higher than us. So you see why the first level of forgiveness gives us the reason to hurt others. I was watching a talk where there were a criminal, a gang leader, a mafia leader, and this guy was describing how his mother did terrible things with him when he was a child. Things what many of us couldn't imagine, wouldn't. I just don't know how to deal with that. There were continuous abuse, continuous suppression, and it built up a kind of anger in this person. And when he was 12, he was hurting others. He was beating up homelessness, and he just wanted to express this anger because he always felt that the story, what happened with him, gave a reason to him to hurt others. He couldn't know how to express. He couldn't know how to forgive. He didn't know how to let it go. And through his life, he started to go into more and more aggression and hurt. First he got hurt, then he hurted back others, then he got hurt, then he hurted back others. And it just got stronger and stronger, up until the point that someone killed his friend while he was protecting him. So that was the time when he first felt like he could actually kill someone. So you see, there is the story, and maybe you have a story. I can remember back all the bullies who were bullying me. I can remember back all the laughter. I can remember back all the shaming. But really, that's just part of my story. And what do I do with it if it's there? What do I do if I feel the pain? Strangely, you have to work with the story first. You have to allow yourself to acknowledge the story first. You have to allow yourself to acknowledge your feelings first. And just express it. express it in a way that's not hurtful. But you have to express, because these are feelings that are trapped in our body, and often we close it down. These things are parts of our being that we consider a shadow, and because we consider a shadow, we don't want to look at it, and because we don't want to look at it, it's still there. But just coming back from time to time in our life, like there are the same triggers, the same person saying the same thing, the same person doing the same thing, and it triggers. We cannot seem to break through that one issue, we cannot seem to break through that relationship issue. The same person coming back, even if we divorce first, second, third time. Because there is a part what we haven't connected with. Because at this level there is a separation. So to heal it, you have to unify it. What means that you first have to unify with your story. You have to acknowledge what happened. You have to acknowledge what you feel. And then you can switch into the second one, the second level. You switch your story into facts. You take away your personal point of view, and you switch your point of view into other points. You maybe observe it from the other person. Remember, hurt people. Like that gang leader, he was hurt. He didn't know how to express, so he expressed by hurting others. So maybe you can imagine yourself in the other person's shoe for a while. Maybe you can think through the things this person went through, and maybe the pain this person feels. You can also observe the situation through, like, if I see this, it means there is something within me why I'm seeing the other person being stupid, being, I don't know, peaceful, being brutal. There must be something within me as well. So this switches the story to something what we can see in a different way. And there is the third level where I would like you to open up yourself to new possibilities. The third level operates on a spiritual level. It says that we are here for a reason. We born into this life to experience what it is. To experience our choice, and however raw it may sound, with every experience we choose, every experience we have we choose. In that level, in that level, there is no story. There are just spiritual beings experiencing the beauty of life with all its positives and negatives, we call it. There are spiritual beings wanting to be hurt, wanting to be loved, wanted to have orgasms, wanted to play, wanted to have jobs, and maybe want to break free from these, want to experience how does it feel to forgive after 10 years, maybe, I don't know. But the thing thing is, if all of these are true, and if we operate from this level, the beauty of it, if we truly realize that this is the case, that we have the choice. We have the choice to interpret the situation in two different ways. Why is it that there are two persons, both of them lost their legs? One of them become depressed, maybe even suicidal. The other person becomes a motivational speaker. Same situation, different interpretation. So once you know that from this level, we choose our experience and we choose how we interpret it. So maybe I had a horrible day. Something happened. My car was stolen. I can be really furious, and maybe I will at the beginning and express it. But then I can observe it from a higher level, go to the second level and observe it like maybe the other person who stole it coming from a life where this is the norm, this is the only way he sees to maybe make a living. Put food on the table or earn respect. On a higher level, I maybe need to go through something. Maybe I need to experience something. Maybe I need to learn something. And also, if you know that you can choose your next experience by using your mind and focusing it on the thing you want. So forgiveness is an internal thing. There is nobody you can forgive to. Nobody needs your forgiveness. I don't need nobody's forgiveness, but we need this personal responsibility. This was my teaching about forgiveness, the three levels of forgiveness. I hope you liked it, you took away something from it. Maybe there is someone you can call. There is something you can make peace with, let go. Maybe you can accept things what happened, accept your feelings and express, and let go what's within. Because that's when things unify. Thank you. Have a great evening.